We all want good results from life, at home, at work, and our relationships with others. So it's important to understand the most important factor that guarantees good results day in and day out is a healthy attitude. So attitude is the magic word. Attitude is the composite of your thoughts, your feelings, and your actions. Now, our attitude will tell the world what we expect. If you have a happy, cheerful, expectant attitude, you're telling everyone you come in contact with that you expect the very best in your dealings. Most people never really actually think about their attitudes at all. You know, the reality is for most of them, it's a matter of beginning each day in neutral. Their attitudes are neither good nor bad. They're ready to react to whatever they may encounter. If what they come across is good, well, they're going to reflect that. And if it's bad, they're going to reflect that as well. They're constantly changing, going through the day, reacting to whatever confronts them. That's why it's very important for us to control our attitudes and make sure that our attitudes are excellent all the time. You know, William James wrote, human beings can alter their lives by altering their attitudes of mind. You know, attitude is probably one of the most commonly used and yet most misunderstood words in the English language. You'll hear teachers tell their students that if they change their attitudes, well, their grades are going to improve. Or sales managers tell salespeople that their attitude controls their sales. Doctors will even tell patients, we've done all we can, now it's up to you. It's your attitude. When we have a good, clear understanding of what attitude is and how attitudes are formed, it'll become very apparent that only a very small percentage of the population are actually in control of their attitudes. In truth, their attitude is being controlled by the media, by other people, by conditions and circumstances in their life. To properly understand attitude, you have to take another look at the relationship of the mind to the body and how the conscious and subconscious mind work and how they work in relationship with one another.